JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for May the 19th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the dollar traded lower against all but two of the other G10 currencies on Monday and during the Asian morning Tuesday. It underperformed the most against NZD, NOK, SEK, and Aussie in that order, while it gained only versus the Japanese yen. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the Swiss franc. The strengthening of the risk-linked currencies combined with the weakening of the dollar and the traditional safe havens yen and franc suggests that risk appetite was boosted yesterday. Indeed, major EU and US indices were a sea of green with a positive investor morale rolling into the Asian session today. There was not a single catalyst behind the rebound in market sentiment. It was rather a cocktail of developments. Firstly, over the weekend, Chair Powell reaffirmed the committee's commitment to that more monetary stimulus could be introduced if deemed necessary, adding that they have not run out of ammunition, even if they prefer to avoid cutting interest rates into negative waters. Powell is scheduled to testify before the Senate Banking Committee today on how the current rescue efforts are working. Now, second, Germany and France called for the creation of a European recovery fund worth of 500 billion euros, aiming at helping the Union exiting the crisis the quickest possible. Last and most important, drug maker Moderna Inc. said that its COVID-19 vaccine trial showed encouraging results. Now, on Friday, we noted that lately it seems there is a battle between those who are afraid that easing the restrictions too soon will result in another wave of exponential spreading of the virus, and those who believe that the peak is behind us and that economies around the globe have entered the road to recovery. Although this pushed us to the sidelines for a while, the latest developments tipped the scale towards more upside. In other words, more monetary and fiscal stimulus combined with speculation that the vaccine could be ready earlier than previously anticipated, and a flattening curve of the virus spreading may allow equities and risk-linked currencies to drift north as investors abandon safer assets like bonds, the dollar, the yen, and the franc. During the European morning today, we already got the UK's employment data for March. The unemployment rate ticked down to 3.9% from 4%, instead of rising to 4.4% as the forecast suggested, while average earnings, including bonuses, slowed more than anticipated. However, although the excluding bonuses rate slid as well, it declined less than its own forecast pointed to. At its latest meeting, the Bank of England said that the current QE is set to reach its target at the beginning of July, which, combined with officials' readiness to take further action if needed, suggests that the QE expansion may be on the cards at the June meeting, even if data continue to come in better than anticipated. Maybe that's why the pound gained only around 20 pips at the time the employment report was out. The British currency tumbled on Friday after negotiations between the EU and the UK led nowhere, and after the Bank of England's chief economist Andy Haldane said that the bank is looking more urgently at negative interest rates. Thus, with the UK Prime Minister Johnson insisting that the Brexit transition period should last until December 31st, the prospect of a no deal exit then, combined with expectations over further easing by the Bank of England, are likely to weigh on the pound, keeping it among the worst performing G10 currencies. Now, as for the rest of today's events, from Germany we have the ZEW survey for May. The current conditions index is expected to have improved somewhat, but to have remained into negative waters. Specifically, it is expected to have increased to -87.8 from -91.5. The economic sentiment index is also expected to have risen to 33.5 from 28.2. The overall picture with regards to the coronavirus suggests a flattening curve since early April, and thus a somewhat more optimistic view by analysts appears more than normal to us. In the US, building permits and housing starts, both for April, are due to be released. Expectations are for both permits and starts to have declined to 1 million and 0.95 million from 1.35 million and 1.22 million respectively. As for the speakers, apart from Fed Chair Powell, we have two more Fed officials on today's agenda, and those are Minneapolis President Neel Kashkari and Boston President Eric Rosengren. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.